mambande roshere maneo. Gigala bota lomongeza ye rane ranungea. Yera sede robodo rane mande romange ranande he hilano. Zera sala lomonge dande gamumbare. Zeso zina. Zesu rabotu sina ye. Uza ye rebosu daba di kayapu. Isa. O sita re mama ki ate alabat. O sara mama ne apura be kutala mane ya. Zo sira be kina e pumba indira. Zo zo mba ye o mama ene ya. O ziza ima ene ala ma inguru. Zo ai hale vari basi e o mma ne ala. Every day, every day, my you go on Musai, may Allah and Badi say to my own Magia. Oh, was it every valley of Bugosi, Dambavan, Marebeo, Serebake Alamo? Oh, see, I live in the Mayaniki Alam, but in Bayavio. Oh, lift your hands unto the Lord your God Most High. Lift your hands like the evening sacrifice and praises. Lift up your gates, oh, ye people. Be lifted up, you everlasting doors. And the King of Glory shall come in. And the glorious realms of heaven shall flow. In. Oh, lift up your voice and praise unto his name. Let songs begin, let shouts begin, let brazen dance before the King. The Lord Most High is his name. Oh, worship him in spirit, and worship him in truth. Worship God the Father's longing for this praise. Nala musike. Oh, malanam beligo. Oh, sitare meme nengalinea. Father, Father, show us how. Father, Father, show us how. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, let the praise from heaven fill our hearts. Let the sharp two-edged sword be in our mouth, and the high praises in our mouth. Oh God, let the sharp two-edged sword be in our hand, and the high praises of God in our mouth. Oh, Most High, let the praise come forth. 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 Praise come forth. Let the praise come forth. Let the praise come forth. Let the praise. Let the praise begin. The praise. Let the praise begin. Let the praise. Let the praise begin in you. Let the praise come forth. You have to do it. You have to open up your mouth and he'll fill it. Just open up your mouth and he'll fill it. The praise come forth. The praise come forth. The high praises of the Lord. The high praises of the Lamb. Let the high praises of God come forth. Let the praise come forth. Let the praise come forth. Let the praise come forth, let the praise come forth. Praise ye the Lord, praise. Praise him, praise him, malanaya. Praise him, praise the Lord. You have to start. Let the praise is loud. Let the praise.
to the Lamb. Let the praise come forth. Let the praise come forth. The praise of the Lamb. The praise of the Lamb. Oh, praise of the Lamb. Let the praise of the Lamb. Let the praise come forth. The praise come forth. The praise of the Lamb. Oh, the praise of the Lamb. The praise of the Lamb. The praise of the Lamb. The praise come forth.
Praise has come forth.
treasure store.
Now singing a whole chapter in the Bible.
Where's my Bible? The other day I sat down and quickly, wasn't the first time, but I memorized a whole chapter of the Bible in like 5 minutes. Oh yeah. Yeah, and some of you understand exactly what I'm talking about, don't you? Because you know the roadmap. You look at the map so long, you don't need to see it anymore. I got it. Psalms 117. The praise of the Lamb. The praise of the Lamb. The praise of the Lamb. Oh, praise the Lord. All ye nations, praise Him. Rejoice in the Lord. All ye people. Blessed is the name of the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord, all you people. For His merciful kindness is great towards us. Say it. Lord, His merciful kindness, yeah, is great towards us, yeah. And His truth endures, the truth of the Lord, His truth endures. The truth of the Lord, the truth endures, the truth of the Lord, the truth endures, the truth of the Lord, forever and ever. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lamb, the praises of the Lamb.
Oh, praise the Lord, all ye people. Praise him, all ye people. Praise him for his merciful kindness is great towards us. And it's true to the Lord, it endureth. Praise him. Oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise him, all ye people, for his merciful kindness is great towards us. And the truth of the Lord endures, it endureth. The truth of the Lord endures, it endureth. And the truth of the Lord endures, it endureth forever. Praise the Lord. Hey. Ha ha. Woo. Woo, woo, woo. Hallelujah! Praise him of the loud sounding cymbals. Praise him on the trumpet. Praise him on the string instruments. Praise him on the chords and the organs and the pianos and the flutes and the wind instruments, and with your voice praise, praise, praise him. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. Say it. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. Say it with me. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth, the high praise of the Lamb. Jesus, high praise of the Lamb. Oh, I will bless the Lord. Come on, lift up your voice. I will bless the Lord at all times. Mom, there's healing, there's miracle, there's signs and wonders, there's gifts, there's laying hold of mantles. This is where it happens. This is where it happens. I tell you, it's where it happens. I tell you, it's where it happens. I tell you, it's where it happens. It's no mystery. It's revealed in you and me by the Holy Ghost. As we lift up our voice, as we open up our mouth, he feels. As we call unto him, he answers and shows us great and mighty things which we have not known. I will praise the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. The high praises of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Woo-hoo! I will bless the Lord. Come your voice. Bring your voice. Oh, I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. The high praises of the Lamb. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. The high praises of the Lamb. Jesus, Son of Man,
Christ Jesus, the great I am. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. Do that with me again. Oh, I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. Do it again. Oh, I will bless the Lord. Oh, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 oh, hallelujah, 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 oh, Jesus, praise his holy name, oh, praise his holy name, oh, praise his holy name forevermore, oh, praise his holy name. Oh, praise his holy name. Oh, praise his holy name forevermore. His name is Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus. His name is Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Praise him forevermore. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Praise his name forevermore. His name is Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus. Praise his name forevermore. Oh, he is worthy, say, Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, Jesus, Christ Jesus, praise his holy name forevermore. Oh, yeah. Jesus, Jesus, Christ Jesus, 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 Christ Jesus, praise the name forevermore. Hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, hallelujah to the name above all name. Oh, hallelujah, oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah to the name above every name. Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, Christ the Lord. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, praise his holy name forevermore. Can't stop singing, can't stop praising. Got to dance and run a little more. Oh, I can't stop praising, can't stop singing. Got to run and shout and dance a little more. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ, Jesus, praise the name of Jesus forevermore. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Christ, Jesus, 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 Christ Jesus, praise the name of Jesus forevermore. Hallelujah. 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 Woo! Woo! Ha ha ha. Oh, rasiketi kopuki anamakachi te pekana mokupa ekita anamasi. Jesus, Jesus, glorious one.
name upon every name. The name that will redeem the life. The name must be proclaimed. And I can see people in the Himalayas, and I can see people throughout Asia now, and I can see people through the mountain regions of Pakistan, Afghanistan, Tajikistan, Kashmir. I can see people who've never heard the name in the jungles of Iran, Jaya, Indonesia. So many places haven't heard. Someone must go in power and in faith. Someone must proclaim the name that's above every name, all power vested in the name of Jesus. Someone must shout out the name with faith and power and authority. The nations, they're crying out to hear. Jesus. Everybody say, Lord, send me. I will go. I will call to you. The Lord said, you have not because you ask not. He said, call unto me, and I will give you the heathen, the lost, for your inheritance in the uttermost parts of the earth for your possession. Oh God, and I can see the dying souls dying by the millions. Never heard about your love. Oh God, I ask for showers, heavenly showers of Holy Ghost empowerment and dew. Oh God, I ask you now for showers for Holy Ghost empowerment, oh Holy Ghost power now and dew. Jesus, Jesus, endued. Well, you can be seated. I don't want to stop, but you know, I like to do church all night, and then, you know, basically when you do church all night, you basically got to sleep all day, or most of it. And I know that many of you can't do that. I wouldn't do it either. Hallelujah. Papa gives us divine energy, divine strength, divine ability. I told Ann on the way here, I said, you know, baby, I'm 57 now. Listen, I want to be shouting, singing, worshiping, dancing, running hard at it when I'm 90 years old. If God has me here when I'm 90, I'm not going to let up. I mean, I don't know what. I'm not going to be decrepit either. I'm not going to be walking around with some cane trying to manage the situation. I just figured that the Lord needs me. Because I really don't see a whole lot of people doing the things that God's given us to do and running for the nations. You know, every time we're in, you know, in the nations and we're getting ready to go, the Lord just, I've just got this thing going on inside of me. Go back, get people to go. Go back and stir people up. And I come back and it's just like, you know, it's like one brother said, the United States of American church is on Quaaludes. Because everybody's just looking like they're, you know, they're medicated or something. And I'm going to tell you right now, that's all going to change. That's all going to change. The millennials are coming. And they're special. They're special. And they're endued with the Holy Ghost and power. Hallelujah. And I might not be in the millennial age group, but I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to jump right in the big middle of it. Praise God. Hallelujah. The nations are calling. Tonight, I'm going to pray over Mike before the meeting's over, because we're going to send him to the mission training center. He's dedicated his life as a human resource to do what we're doing. He's going to be in charge of the things we're doing in horticulture and aquaculture, which is all about raising up a whole army of people in orphanages across Asia and the Middle East. There is a whole army ready to just go be mobilized. They need to be loved on and trained for about 8 years, but they will be so radical when you're done with it. Hallelujah. Oh, God, somebody said, but what if the Lord comes before then? You know, that would be great, but I'm just telling you right now, I don't believe, and I've got 1971 years to back this claim up,
the Father's going to come and remove the salt and the light so long as there's a harvest. And I've watched too many people. I've watched when I stand, we're going to go into Kashmir, we're going to go into Nepal, we're going into other places. I've stand and watched too many people just at the name, spoken name of Jesus begin to sob and weep and run from to me like I've told them they can have $1 billion, whoever gets here first. By the thousands, by the multitudes, as long as there's that kind of harvest going on, I can't help you're stuck in a Western society that was designed by Satan, that was advanced by Alexander the Great. Western civilization has nothing to do with the kingdom of God. The church is supposed to be a heavenly realm. We're supposed to be moving in the realms of the Holy Ghost, representing what's going on in a culture that lasts forever, age without end. We're supposed to be the people that God has made in himself in Christ Jesus, that he reproduced a new race, a greater race than anything that happened when God called Abraham out and Israel was born in Yahovah, Jacob. It's a new race. Born of his blood, hallelujah. Washed of the blood, born of his word, born of the spirit, hallelujah. Come on, people. I pray that Americanism that has taken over this nation comes to an end. Because it's nothing like what my parents, my great-grandparents came here in the early 1600s. That's what they came here about. That's not what they came here. They were Holy Ghost people. They came here with a shout and a prayer and a cry out to God to be able to seek him without restraint, without somebody coming in and busting up the meeting and saying it's heresy. To be able to go after God, to see a bastion of the kingdom of God and a lighthouse for the nation, a place where great men and women of faith would be raised up, and look at what God was able to do in the first 100 years in this nation. People try to give you some kind of demonic history of our nation. Nobody give me no history of my nation. I can't help it that evil men stepped in. Money corrupts people with all their stuff. Listen to me. If Matthew Kuhnkamp is watching tonight, he could be able to vouchsafe this. The Native Americans hosted the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ to come here and explode on the scene with the greatest mission effort that has ever been launched in the history of the church. It's true. Men came with there's other issues going on, but I'm forget about that. All that. I don't want to hear about that. That's what people want to take and spin, you know. Reality of it is most of what you hear is 1% fact, 9% inference of that fact, and then 90% spin, which is nothing but a personal lie invented by an individual or a group of people. There's only one source of truth, that is the Word of God, and only the Holy Ghost can lead us into it. All the rest of the stuff is nonsense. And all the ideas and all the things that people are going after and believing in and want for themselves, it's nonsense. This road is narrow. You must take up your cross to go on it. You must deny yourself, take up your cross, and imitate Jesus Christ to come on this road. I want you to hear me now, because there's a lot of people with a lot of different ideas, and it's not in the Word of God. It's not there. It's not found there. What Jesus said and declared is very evident. Jesus is the living Word that came and fully manifested the written Word, and all of us can consult the written Word to find out who the manifested living Word is so that we can understand what we were born into being when we were created in Christ Jesus, born of an incorruptible seed by the Word of God, which lives and abides forever, born of the resurrection, a people that is now, right now, has their citizenship in heaven, conversation, lifestyle in heaven, seated in heaven with him that is far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named. And it's about time somebody takes a hold of the authority, for God has authorized you. He certified you. He authorized you and gave you the authority. As many as would receive Christ Jesus, he gave them the authority to be a different kind of people, a heavenly people, a people of the Holy Ghost, people that are called the sons of God. Hallelujah. 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 And there's been so many messed up ideas and that's been handed down and handed over that are still holding God's people in bondage. A lie will hold you in bondage. You know, every time I read this particular Greek word, it's only found 5 times, but it is just held hostage some of the glory. This particular Greek word is heothesia. Heothesia is a very odd word to begin with. It's hard to find or attest definitions to it in the Greek community, in the Greek language, and especially in ancient Greek, Attic Greek. But heothesia was translated adoption. And what a bunch of nonsense. What a bunch of nonsense. For every time you find it is in the context of sonship. And it literally means it's abbreviation of huios, heel. Heel means son. Thesia. Thesia means to place as a son. That's what it literally means. By context, it means sonship. Adoption? Nobody's adopted into this. You're born into it.
Yes.
You're born. I can't help it that they didn't even believe in the new birth when the translations were going on. By and large, they didn't even believe or understand you were born from heaven. As hard as that is to comprehend. George Whitfield got a revelation sitting in the park campus at Oxford in England. You know what his revelation was? We must be born of the Spirit. Around 1730, we must be born of the Spirit. He got this revelation, this download. He went everywhere preaching, you must be born of the Spirit. When he started talking about being born of the Holy Ghost, because they didn't even understand the baptism of the Holy Ghost then. I mean, it took somebody to get broken and humbled like Pop Seymour. Who is so sad, even when it was raining, they just cracked the door. And of course, all the white folks had to keep the door cracked because they needed to stay warm. But Pop Seymour went and turned away. Because segregation wasn't going to bother him. He stuck his ear up closer to the door to listen while he was in the cold and the elements. Because they in there talking about baptism and the Holy Ghost. Guess what? None of those guys inside stepped into the realm. But Pop Seymour did, April 9th, 1906, right up here in the street just a little ways. Where people are willing to be broken and they're willing to be conformed in every way, and they don't let conform in every way to the image of the Son, and they don't let any obstacle or situation or hindrance get in their way.
It's about time somebody grows up and quit being such a child. Let stuff stop you and whining and crying about it. Papa's giving you the authority of the ages, that whatever you bind, an authority that whatever you bind on earth, your co-inheritor, hallelujah, bind in heaven. That's where sonship is used. It's used in context like Romans 8:14-17. Go and read it. As many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God. And we've not received the bondage, the spirit of bondage to fear, but we receive the Spirit of the Son. Spirit of the Son. Spirit of sonship. Not adoption. Nobody adopted. You're born from above. Born of the Spirit. Hallelujah.
A new creation. New heart. New spirit. Christ Jesus reproduced in you and me, so we may say Christ is in me. The greater one now resides in me. I mean, so born of God, so changed, so transformed that God moved the holies of holies into our hearts and into our lives. The holiness of revival said, take my will and make it thine, it shall be no longer mine. This is 1880. Take my heart, it is thine own, it shall be your royal throne.
When the doctrines were starting to emerge, where people had submitted themselves to hear the word of God and go after the word of God and break off the yokes of the tyranny that it held the church and much of the population in bondage to heresy and doctrines that have nothing to do with the word of God, doctrines of men and doctrines of devils. Today, the word of God is more available than it ever has been. And people sit around and read books about the Bible, and all they are is disciples of men instead of disciples of the Holy Ghost, disciples of the word of God. It's about time all that change. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And then when you go ahead and read on verse 17, for ye are heirs of God. Hallelujah. And co-inheritors with Jesus Christ. Then when you jump over to Galatians chapter 4 and the other context where that particular word is used, once again, you're not like a child. It differs nothing more from a servant. You're a son. You're a son on the level to where that you stepped in to be able now to administrate the things of the Father. Because as long as you're a child, you're under tutors and governors until the time you're old enough. You hear that? But now Paul says, by the Spirit of the Lord, you old enough because you've been born from above. See, Paul had a revelation in Galatians 1:16 that Father had purposed to reveal his Son in him. And he went immediately for 3 years, conferred not with flesh and blood, and received an abundance of revelation. And you hear about that revelation, you know exactly what he said, received in that revelation, because 2/3 of the New Testament was written out to you and me to explain what God showed him about having the Son, Christ Jesus, revealed in me, in you. This is the thing. To be born from above, you can't enter in or understand this realm or move in this realm. As many as received him, they received authority to be sons of God. As many as will believe on his name. I've seen too many people. See, you step out of this crazy Western civilization and you go to some place like up in northern China on the border of
of North Korea, and you go out into those remote places of Mongolia and along the rim there of Tajikistan and down into the Kashmir Valley and Nepal and along the rim of the Himalayas where people have never heard the name of Jesus, and you'll see them immediately be overwhelmed by the glory of heaven. They'll bust into tears and sobbing, and that name is so beautiful. That name has so much, it touches every cell of their body. I can't help it. His name's become a byword and profane because the church has gone into captivity because of their offense against his holy consecrated things. But there's going to be a change, because Papa's raising up crazy radical people just like me, who forgot about all the respectability imposed upon a society that has no respect. You listen to me. That has no reverence. Doesn't know what reverence is. To honor the sacred, to recognize how sacred God has made us. Do you know that God has called us the sacred ones, the sanctified ones? We are the sanctified. The doctrines of men is you're in a process of being sanctified. Though if you're in a process of sanctified, then you're in a process of being born again. You're not in the Holy Ghost birth canal. Hello. To be given the gift of holiness, to be given the new birth, to be born from above. To be created anew, a new creation. Old things passed away. It's definite. It's final. Buried with Christ. Raised together with him. Alive in him. Seated together with him in a heavenly realm. As long as you're bound up with the doctrines of men, you'll never do much. You'll go on looking like human flesh. Go on looking like and acting like mere men. Instead of the sanctified ones. Saints. God calls us saints 64 times. Every one of his epistles, all the scriptures written to the saints, which is another way of saying sanctified ones, which is another one way of saying holy ones. See, he gave us gift. He gave us in the new birth. He gave us the gift of holiness. We were created in righteousness and true holiness after his image. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 24. People don't want that because they want to bear the image of the earthly. They want to continue to have permission to go on complaining and murmuring and living in sin and squandering their inheritance with some demon spirit. It's about time the holy people of God stand up. It's about time the heavenly people of God stand up. The people that have been born from above, whose life has been transformed by the power of Jesus Christ. The people have become the temple of the Lord. The Holy Ghost is in them and with them. Who've also been baptized in the presence and the glory cloud of heaven. Holy Ghost and fire. Holy Ghost. That teaches us how to speak different, think different, gives us spirit knowledge so we can speak to a rock and the water comes out. Say to an accent float and it does so. Say to the oil and to the flower, do not diminish it. It must obey us. Say to the sun and moon, do not move. I'm not done yet today. Hallelujah. Authority to be sons of God surpasses all of that. Because authority to be sons of God is only defined within Jesus Christ, the person Christ Jesus, the living word, who comes in the low. He says, behold, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me. Genesis 1:1 to Revelation 22:21. It's all written of me to do thy will, O God, to show us. Break off the yoke from off you tonight. The mind-blinding spirit goes from off you, Brandon. Do you make a free? So your passions may be ignited by the Holy Ghost to know what it means to live and breathe in God's world. Where the flame cannot kindle upon you. Where the waters cannot overflow you or overwhelm you and drown you. Where the lion's mouth is shut and you can't be dinner for them. Hallelujah. Where you subdue nations, work righteousness. Obtain promises. Hallelujah. Kapoya Brahma Shikarabo. Mandula Paka Shikahala. Halabada Shikiripala. Mayandeya Purahana. Mangala Mokosha. You can have all the hell you want. I'm taking heaven. You can have all the hell you want. I've been born into heaven. I've been born into joy unspeakable and full of glory. I was created anew. I have no doctrine about some old me. It's dead and crucified and buried with Christ. That thing is gone away. It has no power over me. Somebody said, oh, we restored Adam. That's nonsense. We've been raised up together with the living God. Hallelujah. Who created Adam. Hallelujah. Feel the very spirit of the Lord. But until you agree with God, nothing will change.
I was in Japan, and Japan is free society, a free republic.
Most unreached people, one of the most unreached people groups on the planet.
47th floor in the greatest nation, greatest city in the nation, in the greatest city of the world, almost 27 million people. And I said, Lord, you look very small here. The church is so small here. The impact is so small here. People from the West coming and going, and this place hasn't been moved. What's up, Lord? 5 o'clock in the morning, the Lord woke me up when all Asia is praying. The Lord said to me, he said, Mark, all authority is given to me in heaven and earth. I'm looking for somebody to agree with me. People won't even agree with me about their salvation. They still want to be old. They don't want to be new creatures. They won't even agree with me about my Holy Spirit being in their life, ruling them, ruling their mind and ruling their heart. They won't even agree with the knowledge of the Lord that I have planted within their lives. So the Lord turned the thing back around on me where the problem belongs. Hallelujah. And Father's fault, bemoaning our circumstances and complaining God should be doing more. He's released all power and authority upon his church, which is the fullness of him that filleth all things. I can't help it that we're disinterested in the heavenly inheritance and so busy with our occupations and so busy with all of our mortgage and credit cards and cars and personal issues. We're so filled with personal issues, before long there's going to be a medication for every thought. There's going to be a medication for every behavior. Well, I like to be happy now, take a pill. I want to be sad now, take another pill. Sad pill. I want to go to sleep now, take a sleep pill. I want to wake now, take a wake pill. I want to run now, take a run pill. I want to sit now, take a sit pill. It's already going on, actually. It's already going on. And too much of the insanity is right in the midst of God's people and right in the midst of the church, because you believed a lie and you'll be damned. It's time to believe the truth. People say, oh, why does he have to talk like this? You get anointed with the anointing I'm anointed with, and you'll talk like me too. Just try it on some. Just try it on. Hallelujah. You start getting enough passion to get you out of your living room and quit going back and forth from your house to your job and to the church and your house to the job and to the church, and like Samson going round and round, plowing, you know, basically doing the work of a mule, grinding meal for the Philistines, hair cut off, eyes plucked out. Are you listening to me? Yeah. Hallelujah. Kato Rapancheya. Hamandeko Puyana Sata. Then you get to Galatians 4:7. Once again, he says, in the context of this sonship that we have now received as his sons, praise God. God predestinated us unto sonship, not to the adoption of sons. In fact, all that word would be, if that was true, first of all, heothesia is an adoption. And then they go and add another word, huios, to try to violate the word again. So now really they would have to translate it, place the son's sons. What on earth does that mean? We've been predestinated to walk in the sonship. We've been predestinated in him to sonship. Hallelujah. To be of a different kind, a different breed, a different race. Not earthly anymore, heavenly. My body is his purchased possession that has the very life power of the resurrection in it. Elisha proved it when they threw a captain of the Syrian army in on him. The captain of the Syrian army jumped up from the dead. Huh? That's how resurrection life gets in somebody's bones. Hallelujah. Ha! I tell you right now, if the Lord should tarry and my body should be turned to dust and ashes, I'd have resurrection power in every grain of dust. Yeah. Ha! Resurrection power in every little bit of hair that I would still have laying there in that grave. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hambrusatai. The new birth is not a process. It's a gift. Holiness is not a process. God says, be holy even as I am holy. Where are you going to get that from? It's not a process. It's a gift. The covenant deal is I'll give you my holiness, and I give you the gift of holiness, and I give you my righteousness, and I give you the gift of righteousness so that now you may learn how to walk in holiness and learn how to walk in righteousness. You say you got the gift of holiness and righteousness, and you're not giving yourself over to the leadership of the Spirit of Holiness, the Holy Ghost, who will teach you how to walk in holiness and righteousness. You violated the covenant. You violated and profaned the name. And done and trampled under the foot the blood that sanctified you, that made you holy. He is my righteousness. He is my sanctification. He is my wisdom. Get yourself some spirit knowledge and you can speak to the rock. This is the word of God, the mind of Christ, the mind of the Spirit. All this fluff and stuff and touchy-feely things, I mean, I think it's more demon power than it is anything else. I know what the word of knowledge looks like. It came there out of the mouth of Joseph as he interprets Pharaoh's dream. I know what the word of wisdom is. It's what he should do now that he understands what's getting ready to happen and the administration of things. I know what the word of knowledge and what the word of understanding. Word of knowledge is only used twice in Scripture. That's it. Forgive me. Once in Scripture, once. Word of knowledge, and then twice. Words of knowledge, Proverbs 22. And then, so that's 1 Corinthians, just keep you up, 1 Corinthians 12, 10, Proverbs 22, I believe it is 8. And then the rest of it is knowledge of God, the knowledge of the Lord. It's His Word. It's His Word. It's not all this crazy nonsense stuff. I don't hear any God in it. All I hear is something to lure the lust and the desires and the affections of men into a place segregated away from God and what He wants to do through our lives. Just another religious power. Come on, people. Come on. God said, I will sanctify you by my glory. You'll be sanctified by my glory. I tell you, some of you looking at me like I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to give you some Bible drill just for that look. I'm going to drill you in the Bible. Hallelujah. I want you to know how saintly you are. I want you to know how holy you are. Huh? You were born in sin and every day shaped in iniquity to be just like the devil through the activity of demon spirits that had right to you. When you were born from above, you were born in righteousness to be shaped in holiness every day by the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. Every day to be shaped and formed by the power of God. You're not going to get that sitting around dry labbing it and writing it up on a chalkboard and diagramming it and sending text messages to yourself. You're going to have to read the word of God, jump up and go and do it. Otherwise, it's not living. It's dead. It's dead. God's made us able ministers by the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Haraba. So that the word may be living in us. Praise the name of Jesus. Hebangolo seteya. Come on, man. Come on, man. Just go ahead and shout a little bit. I mean, I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you right now. Father has raised us up with the inheritance of heaven as the heirs of God. That's not just for the future, that's for now. As co-inheritors with Christ Jesus, to go forth doing everything you read about in the book of Acts, to do the very ministry and works of Jesus, to do these works and greater works than Jesus. Because He's living, walking, and breathing inside of us, as it were. Yeah, it's time you get out of your nonsense. Huh? It's time you get out of your excuse for your problem, your excuse for your sin, your excuse for your disease, your excuse for your sickness, your excuse for your slothfulness and lukewarmness, your excuse for why you don't go when you know God told you to get long time ago. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, it's still a couple of people still happy because I'm telling you right now, hallelujah, it's a joyful sound. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Exodus chapter 29, verse 43, God says, and there I will meet with the children of Israel and in the tabernacle, and they shall be sanctified by my glory. And you understand that when God poured it, when Jacob poured out the oil upon the rock at Bethel, it was sanctified. In other words, it was made as a holy, it was consecrated as a holy meeting place where men could meet with God. In a process of being sanctified, poor little rock. You know, someday, little rock, you'll be able to be a place set apart for God so somebody can commune with heaven. Nonsense. Nonsense.
over and again. So the oil was poured out as a representation of the Holy Ghost, even as it was upon Saul's head, and then representing that work of the Holy Ghost that would come upon him and turn him into another man. Not something that took as a process, an anointing, a divine ability that came. This is where the whole word anointing comes from. It starts off with that place sanctified and separated and consecrated, and then emerges into the description of a priest who can stand before the holies of holies, has the right to minister before the living God and on behalf of God to the people. Then all of a sudden it's seen in the emerged in Joshua and Judges as the delivering power of the Messiah, so that the Masach has turned into the Messiah, which we call Messiah, and is there showing the anointing drives out the enemies of God, the delivering power. And you look in Mark chapter 6 and verse 13, you see it converge as they cast out devils and laid oil and anointed them that were sick with oil, and they were healed. Seeing it converge, the Holy Ghost and the anointing oil, the outpouring of the power of God, converge once again as the symbol for what it stood for all the time throughout the Bible. The delivering power, the priestly power. God has made us priests and kings. He's made us sons. He's made us living stones. He's made us branches in the vine to bear the fruit. I mean, it just keeps on going. He's given us his glory that the Father gave him. And we're sitting around twiddling our thumbs waiting for a day to come. Rise up. The millennials are coming. Hallelujah. God's got himself a generation that says whether we live or whether we die, we're going to do exactly what the word of God says. We're done with all your doctrines. We're done with all your manners. We're done with all the things that you say is so important. We're done with all your sickness and your disease. We're all done with all your need for inner healing and all your other nonsense and circumstance, your old man and all your flesh man and all the rest of the stuff that looks counter to what Christ Jesus, the man who now lives inside of me, is. Now, I could say that again if you'd like me to. Hallelujah. Come on, man. It's time to get radical, church. It's time to leave the old folks stuff. Hallelujah. It's time to leave the doctrines of men, the philosophies and the traditions of men that have spoiled us after the rudiments of the world, instead of producing within us the very manner and life of Christ. For the Lord told us to be conformed. He predestinated us to be conformed to the image of the Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Romans 8, 28. I know I always forget the reference. 29. Thanks, baby. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Leviticus 8, 10. And Moses took the anointing oil, and he anointed the tabernacle and all that was therein, and they began the process of sanctification. Let's say that, and they were sanctified. They were consecrated, because Papa's going to show up here in just a few seconds right after this was done, just a few minutes right after this was done. And now it's going to be sanctified on a whole nother level. It's sanctified by his anointing oil. It's sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Were you born of the Holy Ghost? The moment, the time that the Holy Ghost came upon you, a miracle took place. I'm going to tell you, Jesus Christ was conceived by the Holy Ghost. That holy thing that was on the inside of Mary was by the Holy Ghost. You and I have received the miracle, wonderful new creation, the new man, the divine nature by the Holy Ghost. An event of glorious sanctification where God made us his very temple, where the Holy Ghost lives and abides in us, where Father moved the holies into our heart, where Christ Jesus lives in us and he's come with the Father also. As you sit there trying to contain yourself and process with your head, Father, let your Holy Ghost flame torch be here tonight. Flamethrower in Jesus' name. Burn up the chaff. Bust up the rocks. Hallelujah. No, it was sanctified 64 times. God calls us, well, God doesn't really call us. One time, you could say that it was the Lord saying that we were Christians, calling us Christians at Antioch. Twice, God's people are called Christians in the Bible. 64 times, we're called saints, the sanctified ones, the holy people of God, the Hagios, the Kadosh, hallelujah, those filled with the hallelujah, the Spirit of the Lord. The Kadosh Ruach, Spirit that is holy, the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Kamada Kishipa. Ayedemapukina. Ha Kimalias. I belong to God. I'm 100% His. Ain't no part of me devil.
I've been born of the Spirit. I've been washed in the blood. My garments are whiter than snow. I'm spotless. I'm preserved in Him, spirit, soul, and body, to be found in Him and to praise, honor, and glory. Hallelujah. Woo! I'm in Jesus, and Jesus is in me. I dwell in Him, and His Word dwells in me. The anointing teaches us all things, and we don't need anyone to teach us, but the same anointing teaches us, and is true, and is no lie, that we're to dwell in Him. That's what the anointing does. Hallelujah. It's not this touchy-feely thing. It's a power to move mountains around and command sycamine trees to be planted in the ocean, a spirit knowledge power as an heir of God and a co-inheritor with Jesus to go shake nations, subdue nations. Hallelujah. To work righteousness, escape the edge of the sword. Hallelujah. Shut the mouths of lions. Hallelujah. Hamru matakia. Out of weakness be made strong. Hallelujah. Wax valiant and fight. Put to flight the aliens. Every demon spirit. The delivering power of the anointing. Ah, the anointing is that which protects. It is that which causes that one who is anointed to not even be able to fall. David said, how is it the saw fell as one not anointed? How is it that his instruments of war has perished as though they had not been anointed? Oh, there's a protection there. Oh, there's a provision there. Oh, there's a perfection there. Oh, there's a work of divine power and grace. God, the Holy Ghost is right here in this place, walking on the inside of me, a wellspring springing up continually, rivers pouring out, an eternal and unending deluge of the flood of the very power of Almighty God. That's the salvation Jesus described. I don't want the one that many Christians reside in and confess as they live in their depression, which is nothing more than an afflicting, tormenting demon spirit hovering over top their head. The redeemed of the Lord have returned and come with singing unto Zion, and everlasting joy has crowned them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I was watching A.A. Allen on a YouTube cast a devil out of a woman the other day. And he said, look at this woman. See her face? See, you can see she's oppressed of an evil spirit. Look at that melancholy and depression. I thought, my goodness, that looks like the majority of the church today. I don't think he would be very popular with that today. Huh? We walk around waiting to hear something that's going to offend us. What's going to offend us today? The spirit of offense is one of Satan's big weapons against the people of God, to hold them in a prison so that they can't move in, get them basically rooted in unforgiveness where they can't even begin to touch the realms of God in terms of His love, and to know and believe the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, is the entrance in to being able to be filled with all the fullness. And if something's available to you right now, because unto Him who is able to do superabundantly above all you can think or ask, according to a divine power in heaven that you got to pray down.
How many people believe that? I don't believe it. I don't believe that. That ain't it. Because somebody done changed the last couple of words and made it like what we practice, the orthopraxy. You want orthopraxy that looks like orthodoxy, hallelujah. According to His power that is at work in us. Now, unto Him is able to do superabundantly above all that we can think or ask, according to the power that is in us, that is at work in us, according to a treasure chest that has been put on the inside of us. The Holy Ghost is with us and in us. My goodness, this new birth, this wellspring, this divine nature, this glorious river that is pouring forth from our innermost being with the effulgency of everything that expresses the very life and character and nature of Almighty God. I don't know who you are, but that's who I am, because that's what the great I Am said about who I am, so therefore I am that. Hallelujah. And I want you to be that. I want to wash your mind tonight with the Word of God. We want the fire of God to burn up all the chaff, the doctrines of men. We want the hammer of God to come crush everything that's standing in the way. Turn it into soil. Did you know that good crushed rock makes good soil?
Yes.
Huh? It does. Hallelujah. Good planting soil. Produce great grapes. Hallelujah. Big old grapes. How about side the big sipa? Perfect environment for a vine to produce branches and huge clusters of fruit. Believe the word and live. Know the truth and be liberated. Somebody told me the other day, said, you're a phenomenon. So you get up and you just speak scriptures.
That's sad. I pray that you'll get up and you'll just speak scriptures. I pray, you get up and just tell it like it is by the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want the salvation that Jesus described, not some preacher.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm a churchman. It's in my blood. My daddy's a preacher. My grandfather, my great-grandfather just goes all the way back.
I just, I've been authorized. Hallelujah. Talk like this.
Somebody said, he's reckless. I'm not reckless. It's abandoned.
It's total abandonment to declare to God's people those things the Father has to say and not diminish one word. Hallelujah. Well, let's just go and just see if this checks out. I mean, we could go on and on and on with verse after verse after verse of how just the application of the oil, which represents the Holy Ghost, immediately sanctifies the people, the vessels, the clothing, and every part and dimension of that which is going to be used in interacting with Father. Anything that Father is going to be around is going to be sanctified by that which represents the Holy Ghost. Now let's go see if that works over here in New Testament, 1 Peter chapter 1. Yeah. Verse 2, elect according to the foreknowledge of God. That's where people get all confused. They just stop there. They don't read anything else. They just stuck there. They thinking about it and coming up with all kinds of crazy ideas. Go ahead and read the rest of it, man. Don't get stuck there. Through sanctification of the Spirit. You're going to have to understand that within the framework of the new birth, not some crazy theological idea. Jesus said to Nicodemus, you must be born of the Spirit. You must be born of the Holy Ghost, the miracle of the new birth. When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, that holy thing that is conceived on the inside of you belongs to the very person of Almighty God, the new man, the new creation, Christ formed in you, Christ in you, the hope of glory, the greater one that lives on the inside of you. You no longer live, it's Christ that lives, this wonderful new man formed in you. Amen.
Amen.
Those are just pieces of verses of scripture in case you didn't know, because a lot of people don't even know. They just think I'm just rapping. Sanctification comes the moment the Holy Ghost touches you. And obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. 2 Thessalonians 2:13 says the same thing. But he says, but we are bound to give thanks always to God for you, brethren, beloved of the Lord, because God hath from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit. As soon as the Holy Ghost comes upon you, the moment that you're born of the Spirit, the moment you're born from above, the moment you become a new creation, the moment you become a temple of the Holy Ghost, the moment that Jesus Christ is formed in you, the moment that you can say that you've made alive in Christ Jesus, at the moment that you have been set apart, sanctified, made a saint, given the gift of holiness, given the gift of sanctification, given the gift of righteousness, given the gift of Jesus, given the gift of salvation. Would you stop thinking like you've been thinking and start thinking like Jesus? I'm not even talking to people with an unregenerated mind. There's the concept of the unregenerated mind and the mind of the Spirit. I'm talking about people who need to understand how to use the weapons of the warfare to begin to deal with these rational, logical thinking of men, which was translated imagination. Logismos is the Greek language. In the Greek language, is the Greek word there used in the Greek language in the Greek text. If you're looking at a Greek text right now, it's logismos. It's logical, rational thinking of men. You need that to drive home, but you don't need that to understand what God's done for you. All you need is the knowledge of God. You need to start agreeing with God about who he said you are, who he's made you in Christ Jesus, and quit trying to be something in the devil. And quit trying to be something in the world. And quit trying to be something just mere men. And quit trying to create a doctrine centered around your problem. Rather, believe the word of God and get set free from your issue. I'm not going to be with you for a while. I got to get it all out tonight. I'm going to go up minister in Washington State. Hallelujah. Now I'm going to come back, and then I'm going to go up minister in North Dakota. And I'm going to come back and get you for a little bit. Then we're going to go minister in Alabama and Georgia and Mississippi. Those people really need to be set free down there, man. Jesus. God. Hallelujah. They need to understand what race they are up down there.
2 Thessalonians 2:13. I read that, didn't I? Hallelujah. Bakayalasht. He said, God hath from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of the truth. You're not even saved. You're not even born again if you're not sanctified. It's not some process, some second work of grace. It's a synonym with a gift of holiness. It's a synonym, sanctification. People get all messed up. Sanctification is simply the empowerment of the Holy Ghost and that has been given to us to live the life of Jesus as a new creation. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I tell you right now, somebody said, I don't agree. You know what? You may not agree, but my doctrine's sound. You may not agree, but my doctrine is sound. And it's the faith that is all found in the new birth. Circumcision, uncircumcision matters nothing to the Lord. A new creation's all that matters. He says to Nicodemus, you can't enter in, you can't understand, you can't see, you can't know until you're born of the Spirit. Hallelujah. And now Paul comes along, begins to break that down in Romans chapter 8 and tells us you're not in the flesh but in the Spirit because you've been born of God, because you've made children of God, sons of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Huyo tu tion. Huyo tu tios. Huyo tu tiu. Sons of God. If you can't get it in English, we'll do it in Greek. We'll get over to Latin here in a few minutes. Go back to Hebrew. We'll maybe do some Espanol for you. Whatever's going to work. Works better than all the rest. Except for the word of God being spoken. Speaking right into your spirit, trying to wake you up from your sleep and your slumber. Begin to let the life of God spring up. Begin to live the big life. To say, I no longer live. It's Christ that lives. Hallelujah. It's Jesus that lives. I no longer live. My life has been fully exchanged. I no longer have a mere human existence. Yeah, I bore the image of the earthly, but now it's time to bear the image of the heavenly also. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. Sometimes I think I'm the only one happy in the meeting. People are hearing the good news and feeling like it's bad. No, it's a reason to rejoice. If you want to hang out in the world, this may be bad news for you. Jesus didn't die for those who wanted to continue on in sin. He died for those who want to be delivered out of everything that belongs to a realm of darkness. And he came and he delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of the dear Son. Hallelujah. I'm walking around in the kingdom right now. For the kingdom of God's not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. I'm living in the Holy Ghost right now, the Spirit of holiness, the sanctifying Spirit. Do you grow in holiness after receiving the gift of holiness? Absolutely. Do you grow in righteousness after receiving the gift of righteousness? Absolutely. Do you grow in the realms of the new man after receiving the new man? Absolutely. As newborn babes, you desire the sincere milk of the word so that you may grow into all the fullness of the maturity, the measure of the ministry of Jesus Christ, even unto a fully matured man. Hallelujah. To be no longer children tossed to and fro. Huh? Not to be just little children and need a little bit of milk, diluted with some water, but now to come to full age and maturity. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Man, it's happening right now. It's happening to some of you right now. I see some of you grow about 3 foot right now, right in front of me. Hallelujah. Gosh, shut up. Just sprout right up. God, I day not. Kana manje akaya. Hallelujah. Woo! I mean, I feel like running, so I'm just going to go through the motions. Hallelujah. King Namoshea. Hallelujah. Hebrews 10:10. By the which, through which we were sanctified by the offering of the body of Jesus Christ. I get sanctified anywhere else but at the cross by that which Jesus did for me. When I believed him, when I called upon his name, I was changed. Hallelujah. The old passed away and behold, everything became new. See, the reason people don't walk with God is they don't know how sacred they are. They don't know how holy they are. They don't know that Father has made us a place that is, as it were, almost more sacred than the holies of holies that dwelt in the temple and the tabernacle made without, and the tabernacle rather made with hands. So we can begin to understand what it looks like to interact with in the tabernacle made without hands. When you begin to believe that the Holy Ghost fills you up to the full and there's a wellspring of life springing up on the inside of you just because you took a drink of this wonderful gift of God, you recognize who Jesus is and was and the gift of God. And suddenly a new creation sprang up and the life-giving flow of the very nature and character and power and presence of the living God who creates all things new began to spring up in you. And then Father just took it to another level and produced a river too. This spake he of the Holy Ghost, which was not yet given, for he was not yet glorified. You just begin to agree with God. You begin to quote his word. You begin to meditate on his word. You begin to recite his word day and night. Then you'll have good success and you'll discover the prosperity in his word. You'll discover the miracle that is there because you believe the word, because the faith of, that works the miracle comes by hearing the word. It's agreeing with the word and doing it and moving with God. Who has believed our report? Who has believed our report? Yeah, I know it's amazing to think that God has done all this for us, and on top of that, he went and baptized us the Holy Ghost and fire. You talk about the Holy Ghost with you and in you, then you baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. Give me a break. In that day, you should know God said, I'm in you and you're in me. In that day, Jesus said, you'll know that I'm in the Father and that the Father's in me and that I'm in you. In that day, you'll know that the Father's in me and that I'm in you. In that day, you'll know that the Father's in me and that I'm in you. That's a wonderful message of John chapter 14, verses 17 through 22. Come on, people. Let's start reading the Word of God. Start agreeing with what God says until all this crazy nonsense that people are going around espousing that is primarily formed in the jaws of hell. Right out of the heart of the devil, out of a demonic power. And look at people. They're held in bondage, don't know how to live in free from sin. Don't know how to live free from iniquity. The proof, God's primary proof in his word is that you live free from sin. That you overcome even as he overcame. We know that everyone who's born of God doesn't sin. That, today you have to say, well, they knew that. Because we don't know that. We think something different. They believed that they taught that salvation was all about believing with your heart that you were righteous. Today it's believing with your heart that you're unrighteous. That sounds like antichrist, stinking, seducing spirit, apostate church to me. Apostasy. That's going to sweep the world away. Sweep all, ultimately, if the days aren't short and the very elect would be deceived. I'm not having it. I'm staying right up here in the Word of God. I'm staying right up here buried in the realms of the glory of the Holy Ghost. I'm going to obey God. I'm going to be far away from sin as day is from night. Tell me God can't keep you from some little stick demon paralyzed from the neck down, blind in both eyes, deaf in both ears, can't speak. Give me a break. Somehow Satan's bigger than God. Somehow the new creation is less than the sin of Adam and the bondage that it brought. Somehow Satan's stronghold is greater than Christ Jesus' liberation. Somehow Adam's disobedience is greater than Christ Jesus' obedience. Somehow that realm of sin and death is greater than the liberation of righteousness and freedom in Christ Jesus. Give me a break. Problem is people don't even have doctrine. They got abstract ideas basically put together in some kind of a weird, illogical fashion. And everybody's shouting hallelujah. Papa's going to bring an end to it. He's going to glorify his only begotten son. He's going to make a distinction between the holy and the profane. He's gone in his mercy and his grace. Say, here it is. Walk ye in it. And of course, he's already done it over and over again. You got a Bible in your hands. Read it. You spend 5 minutes a day reading the Bible. You'll read through it. You'll read through it in a year. 2-3 chapters a day. You'll read through it in a year. 10 years, you'll read through it 10 times. You spend 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes. You'll read through the Bible twice in 1 year. Huh? Then you just go ahead and move that up to 30, 45 minutes. You'll read through the Bible 3 times, 4 times in a year. And then all of a sudden, you'll be changed.
Because you'll start believing according to God's doctrine instead of everybody else's doctrine. You're sitting there in front of the Word, Holy Ghost talking to you. My goodness, everything about your life. Constantly you'll be reading the Word, the Holy Ghost reach up and slap you. Say, quit acting like that. You got to be different. This is what I created you to be. Take a hold of the miracle power of God's Word. Hallelujah. Eat it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And of course, you know, of course, Hebrews 10:29 says this. Says, and of course, you get right to the main point. Says they counted the blood of the covenant by which they were sanctified. How are you sanctified? How are you sanctified? I was sanctified by the blood of the covenant. I was sanctified when the Holy Ghost came upon me. I was sanctified by believing the truth. I was sanctified by the very presence of the Lord. What process are you going through? Huh? I mean, I just, you know, I heard the Spirit of the Lord say to me, people just think they're in the birth canal of the Holy Ghost. Are you born again? Are you born from above or not? Yes. Then you God's. You're holy. You belong to Him. You're not your own. You bought with a price. You're not your own. That by definition is sanctified. You bought with your own. And you bought with a price. You're not your own. That by definition is sanctified. I'm being bought with a price, and I'm becoming not my own. Old things are passing away, and behold, all things are becoming new. That's the process of sanctification. That's the process of being born again. You can't have it both ways. The event has either happened or it hasn't happened. Come on, people. I'm talking to you tonight about this because I want you to grab a hold of how sacred you are. I want you to understand that God has fully resourced you. He's given you the gift of His only begotten Son. He's given you the gift of salvation. He's given you the gift of the Holy Ghost. He's given you the very precious things. And people sitting around are living under condemnation and guilt and shame. And they don't even have a propensity to understand how to come and enjoy the goodness of God and stand in the beauty of His presence and have a Holy Ghost meeting outside of church. Most people don't even understand what that means. Prayer is some kind of boring, agonizing thing that you need tissues and it sounds like you're cutting yourself doing it. Are you listening to me? It has no real expression of the divine power of glory. It has no real expression of the all prayer and supplication in the Spirit was watching thereunto with thanksgiving. It has no real expression of praying in the Holy Ghost, building yourself up in the most holy faith. It has no real expression of the wonderful translation and transfiguration. Hallelujah. That Jesus modeled for us when He prayed. Yes. Hallelujah. Yeah. That the Scripture says, don't be conformed to this world, but be transfigured by thinking different. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, metamorpho. I'm on the sick end of myself, it'd be easier for me. Metamorpho is used in the transfiguration. It's consecrated there when Jesus was transfigured. So when we go over in Romans 12:2, I don't want to go some other word. I want you transfigured. I want you the same word. I'll make sure everybody's making the connection of where the connection's supposed to be made. Yeah. Instead of it being some kind of process. Huh? Instead of being some kind of process, I want you to go ahead and get a hold of the gift. And now that you've been given the gift, and now that you've been certified, and now that you've been authorized, and now that you've been given the authority, and now that you're the dwelling place of the living God, now you'll have freedom and ability to go ahead and walk out in the fullness of the glory of it, not live under condemnation and shame and guilt, and run and hide every time God speaks with your little fig leaves sewn together. Which is a crazy concept of how to get the job done. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm having fun. Some of you look like you're having a really, really rough time. Hebrews 2:11. For both he that sanctifieth and they that are sanctified are all one. God says, be holy even as I'm holy. Be pure even as I'm pure. Walk even as I walk. As I am, so are you now in this world. Be perfect even as I am perfect. That's what he said. That's what he said. Ha! Overcome just like I overcome. I can keep on going. I can keep on. Where are you going to get that? It's a gift. It comes to you. And now the ability of the Holy Ghost. Forget about the conceited legalism that thinks that you can do it on your own. And somehow through some process of your own effort, you're going to somehow be more acceptable unto God. That is, you've fallen from grace. You've fallen from grace. You made void the grace of God. You accept the gift. Accept the gift. Accept the gift. Amen. Believe. Amen. Believe in a miracle. Believe the word of God and a miracle will produce. By the very simple act of believing the word of God and obeying the word of God, just receiving what he's given, you'll receive sonship. You'll receive the authority to be a son. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when we see him, we'll see him as he is, for we shall be like him. And everybody who has this hope purifieth himself even as he is pure, so that we may walk even as he walks. Because we're righteous even as he is righteous. Huh? To be holy just like he is holy. Hallelujah. Because as he is, so are we right now in this world. To be perfect even as your Father in heaven is perfect. Come on. This is the word of God. This is the word of truth. This is the word of life. People look at it and go, I can't do that for myself. No kidding. And so now you're going to make it something different. You're going to somehow make it something other than what God says. You're going to come and interpret God's word for us. We don't need no sages. We're not mystics. We've been converted to become like little children so that we can receive the sincere nourishment of the word of God. Hallelujah. As newborn babes, taught of the Father, you taught of the Holy Ghost, kept by him. He loves us so much, he counts the hair upon our heads. He catches every one of our tears in his bottle. You never loved nobody like that. Not even yourself. Anybody store up your tears? I must admit, I've never caught one of my tears. I would think of myself kind of strange or weird if I had it. Oh, I tell you, I got some of my tears here tonight. But Father, he has. He loves us so much. Who is affections? His affections. Hallelujah. His great love for us. I mean, he's like, hey, listen. Here he's calling us. He says, if you be risen with Christ, if you then be risen with Christ, set your affections on things above, not on things of this world. For you dead, 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 you double dead, you dead, you dead, you crucified and buried, you dead. There's no resurrection until you die. Ah, people being crucified and dying, you agonizing thing. Die. Get it done with. Be dead. Be dead. For you're dead. And your life is hid with God in Christ. So that when Christ, who is your life, appears, you shall also appear with him in glory. Yeah. Knowing the severity of God, we thus persuade men that if one died for all, then all are dead, that we should henceforth no longer live unto ourselves, but unto him who died for us and rose again. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things are new, and all things are of God. Arabakitaya. All. I belong to him. I don't want to be any part mine. And neither do you, the moment especially you breathe out your last breath. You want to be belonging to God. All these people that are going through this process of sanctification, always talking about laying aside the sin, the weight so easily besets them, they never got the job done. They lived, they died talking about it. They're still old guys. Still talking the same nonsense. You can never have the miracle of it till you agree with the power of it. Just accept what God has done, and all of a sudden you'll receive and believe all the things that has already been written of you, and it'll begin to be fully made manifest. True. No, people don't understand what I'm talking about because they've never agreed with it. They've never believed. They lived in another doctrine that has no authority or power. They prophesied wrong things over themselves. They prophesied bondage and captivity and imprisonment. I'm telling you right now, the Spirit of the Lord has anointed me. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus to the ones who want to be made rich. Hallelujah. With the riches that Christ Jesus had when he was rich and became poor for our sake, that through his poverty we might be made rich. That kind of poverty and those kinds of riches. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ooh, to bind up the broken in heart by the anointing going forth, the word spoken, being healed by the power of God, being transformed instantaneously in a moment and twinkling by, being made a new creation instantaneously. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon you, look how long it took Saul. Look how long it took. And we get to really see a very fine picture of Saul there. Isn't that amazing? Look how long it took Mary to get pregnant. Years. Years. Years of agonizing. Years of prayer and intercession. After that, the Lord brought the word, you know. Years went by. I mean, she was like 14 when the Lord gave her the word, and she was like 60 when she finally gave birth. But that's the way everybody makes it. That's the way you make it. You distill it out to now interpolate it or extrapolate it to be that's what it's like in your life. No, as soon as the word come, it happened. Yeah. Hallelujah. Amen. She said, be it unto me according to thy word. Bang! It happened. Hallelujah. Done! The Spirit of the Lord came upon her. Woo! Hallelujah. As she was prophesying, as she was speaking, that was all the Holy Ghost moving on her. Huh? Yeah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The word, the spoken word that transfers the anointing. Just like the pouring out of the oil upon the head or the laying of hands as Moses laid his hands upon Joshua. The spoken word of Mary saying hello to Elizabeth. John the Baptist in her womb, third trimester, full of the Holy Ghost, began to leap with joy on the inside. Can you see it? The baby is jumping up and down inside of me with joy. She knew he was happy because she was happy. Hallelujah. It's a lot to learn there, moms. I'm not going to go into that. Don't give birth to sad kids.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stay joyous and in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. My kids always crying because you was crying for 9 months before you had them. You was whining and murmuring and complaining, doing just what God got so sick and tired of. He said, Mom, tell you right now, I'm done with this. He did. He said, I'm done with this. I'm telling you right now, though the work was finished from the foundation of the world, I'm telling you right now, I swear to you, not coming in. I'm done with the murmuring and complaining. I mean, if we just get it, you know, we're like, well, I don't want to be doing that. I mean, I'm not going to do this. I don't want to have that same effect on me. I'm going to rejoice. I'm going to get happy. I'm going to give thanks. I'm going to give praise. I'm going to praise continually. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be continually in my mouth. I shall make my boast in thee, Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Evening and morning and noon will I pray, and I will cry unto the Lord. Yeah. He shall hear my voice. He shall hear my voice. Yeah. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on, people. Yeah, you're going to have to break through a troop. Yeah, you're going to have to deal with opposing spirits of darkness that will try to oppress you and stop you and shut you down. But get yourself a fresh touch from heaven. Get yourself an endowment with power from on high. It's available for you. You can be continually filled. Hallelujah. You'll break into a whole other realm of glory. You won't be religious anymore. You'll begin to understand what relationship's all about. I'm trying to do this quickly because I know some of you have got to get up early and go to work. And you haven't understood how to step into the refreshing anointing yet to be able to deal with it. But in the day of his power, there'll be ability. You let that day of his power come. Huh? All the great revivals were all-night meetings in the past. So much so, people started thinking revival wasn't born until after midnight. But that wasn't the truth. Huh? I'm believing for a great moving of the power of God. I'm believing Father and His mercy will come and we'll begin to sovereignly move as He's done over and over again through the generations of men. But only those people who are laboring together in His husbandry and building together in His building are going to be able to discern how to move forward when He comes with His sovereign moving of His Spirit. We're going to have to be doing those things which He's doing, going after those things which He's purposed for us to have. Otherwise, we'll be on the sidelines. Watching as the great power of God passes by us. We'll be up in the bleachers waving, praising God and shouting the victory. Oh, look at the beauty and the splendor of heaven. I'm going to be down in the middle of the parade. Give me a break. Come on, you need to be down in the big middle of the signs and wonders and exploits of heaven. Who wants a bleacher seat in glory? Who wants the nosebleed section so far back you can't even hardly see Jesus? Man, you need to be rehearsing to be front and center, to be the one who gets to be the number one praiser in heaven. James and John had it right, man. They were buying for the right and left-hand position. Come on, man. Come on now. Come on now. Where's your passion? Where's your heart? You're supposed to have the Spirit of the Son on the inside of you crying, Dad, God is my dad. Abba, Father. Abba, Tosipi. Abba, Kanishia. Halabosarenekia. Hallelujah. Paul writes this over and again, like he does in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 2, unto the church of God, which is at Corinth, to them that are in the process of being sanctified. Paul never said that one time. Augustine said that. Luther said that. Calvin said that. And all the other nonsensers said that. They don't have one verse of scripture in the Bible. Paul said you are. And this is for you, those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called of God. It's about time we start believing God's word, then we can have his miracle. You don't believe God's word, you're not going to have his miracle. You don't believe God's word, you're not going to have his faith that produces the miracle, and you'll stay as you are. You'll never change. You'll never have power to change or authority to change. You're going to have to start speaking God's word no matter what circumstance and situation tries to tell you around you. Hello. You have to recite his word day and night that you may observe to do everything that is written therein, so that you may make your way prosperous and have good success. That is the marching orders into your inheritance, both then and now. And our inheritance is this glory realm of heirs of God and co-inheritors with Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul. That's why I'm so excited. Because I have believed. I have believed the good report. I refuse all bad reports. I laugh at bad reports. It's such a joke. Bad reports are such a joke. It's a bad joke. But it's still funny. It's like, you think I'm going to believe your lie, devil? I'm bathed, baptized, washed in the truth. I'm filled up with the truth, the spirit of truth, hallelujah. Surrounded by the spirit of truth. The truth person lives on the inside of me. Christ, the truth, the life, the way is here. And plus, I read the Bible every day. I study his word every day. Hallelujah. I find great comfort in his word. Yeah. To me, his word is spirit and life. It's not black ink on white paper. Spirit and life, just by the very activity, I'm so hungry for him. Events happen in my life by the miraculous power that spoke the universe into existence. And we want the same thing to be happening to you. That's why we're talking to you like this tonight. But see, verse 30 tells us how it is. But of him are you in Christ Jesus, who of God is made for you your wisdom, your righteousness, your sanctification, and your redemption. He is all my righteousness. True. He's all my sanctification. He's all my holiness. He's all my life. Outside of him, I'm nothing. Without him, I can do nothing, and neither can you. I have the life of God. I received the life of Jesus. I have the life of the Holy Ghost. I have the life of the Father. I'm living out his life. He's put his life in me. I've been created anew, given capacity to grow and realize and understand and have all that he himself possesses. He's freely given it to me. He's taken all that he has, and he's revealed it, transferred it into me by the Holy Ghost. It's expedient for you that I go away, for if I go not away, the Comforter, the Holy Ghost, cannot come. When he comes, he will lead you and guide you in all truth. He will take of the Father. He will take of mine and reveal it unto you, transmit it, disclose it to you. All that the Father has is mine. Therefore, I said, he should take of mine and reveal it, transfer it, transmit it unto you. Hallelujah. And if you don't know what that is, everybody should know that scripture, right? I shouldn't have to quote that scripture, right? I don't need to come up with that reference for you, right? You know about that gold mine. You've been digging in that gold mine, right? You know about that treasure chest. You've been meditating on that already, right? John 16, 12 through 15. We need to start believing and meditating on what God says instead of meditating and believing on what we thought and what somebody else thought and all the stuff we've been trained in Western civilization since preschool. Now they got preschool. They started kids at 3 years old now. What are you teaching them, man? They're getting them all conditioned for the full impartation of a demonic stronghold. Full impartation. And don't mention Jesus, because it might mess with the full demonization of them. Because we know the name of Jesus has power, so shut down the name of Jesus. You can have the Quran around here because it has no power, but don't have the Bible around here. It's going to mess up our demonization of these people. I wish I was a teacher in a public school system. I probably wouldn't last long. I just keep getting, go from school to school, getting hired different places. Amen. Preach as long as I can. And then shake the dust off your feet and go to the next campus. No, I believe that God would, I believe that there was some valiant people, somebody somewhere began to make a stand, and their occupation and their money wasn't so big of a God to them anymore. They'd stand up and Father would find somebody to begin to work through and work alongside of and turn the thing upside down. Somebody would all of a sudden understand that the anointing is a delivering power that will set people free, that will break off the yoke, that will change the very conditions of humanity and society. Oh yeah, as soon as we start walking in the authority of the sons of God. Stop believing all this other nonsense about being somebody else. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And I'm Magesh Kubata. You can act like human beings if you want, which are made in the image of the devil. You can fit into this society which was designed by the satanic mind. But I've been delivered. And I'm walking with the King. I'm walking in a heavenly realm. I want to be just like Him. I want nothing to do with the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. I don't care about all the popular opinions. It's nonsense to me. It's weird. It's freaked out and twisted. It belongs in an insane asylum. There's nothing normal or natural about it. And one day it will be in the great insane asylum called the Lake of Fire and contained there forever. Praise God. And that'll be a day of shouting and singing and praises to the King. He's coming with his eyes a flame of fire. Hair like white like wool. His whole body looks like he's been on fire in the fire and burning. Hallelujah. And he's coming with 10,000s of the saints to execute judgment upon all the ungodly for the ungodly deeds which they've ungodly committed. That's why God's given us everything that pertains to life and godliness, because He's called us to glory and virtue. But according to His divine power, according to the power that He Himself possesses, He's given to us everything that we need that pertains to godliness, that pertains to life, so that we can walk in His glory, so that we can walk in His virtue. He's given us the ability to be strong in His strength and the power of His might to effectively deal with every spiritual wickedness and stronghold. It's about time God's people quit playing little charismatic games, crazy-matic games, and start grabbing a hold of the real charisma, the anointing, the authority of sonship, the authority of the name of Jesus Christ, the authority of the Holy Ghost. Baba stirred me up. His zeal has consumed me. I'm getting ready to get real radical. I feel an explosion coming on. I'm about ready to get as intolerable as you possibly can to humanity. Hallelujah. God was talking to me today about how popular Jesus and the anointing is. He said, Herod, Pontius Pilate, the Gentiles, and all the people of Israel were set against Him. Come join in on His side. Come stand with Him. That's how popular the anointing is. Jesus said, the world hates me. The church run around trying to relate to the world. Yeah. Oh, we want to go relate to the world. We want to identify with the world. Yeah, you go identify with the world. You're going to end up right where they at too, eternally. Because you give plenty of room to Satan. Give him some wiggle room, he'll take over. He deceived the mighty angels that stood before God throughout eternity. What are you going to do to you? He's the master of his craft. He's the master of deception. He's a formidable foe that none of us are a match for. You better be buried deep in the living word. You better be surrounded by the Spirit of truth, the Holy Ghost, who's only speaking the word of truth. God's made you sacred. He's made you holy. I think that what people need to grab a hold of more than anything else is just understanding the gift of holiness, the gift of righteousness, the gift of redemption, the gift of the new birth. Everybody preaches it. They say, you can come right now, call upon the name of the Lord Jesus, and you'll be born from above. You'll be made a new creation. You'll be made a new creature. And then they basically take everybody from there and set them all the way back to where now they got to go through some long, drawn-out process. Well, wait a minute. I thought we got it all done over here. I thought we got it all done. Well, all these people got all these issues. I became so violently mad because I went into this house and I saw this woman. And I looked at her and I saw this woman. I saw this demon-possessed woman. And it kind of startled me. Because I went into this house. I went into this house, possessed by the Holy Ghost people. And I walked in and I saw this demon-possessed woman. And it startled me. And she said, and she comes to me, "Oh, Mark." And, you know. And I didn't even recognize her. Then all of a sudden I recognized who it was. I said her name. I said, "What's going on?" Well, she went over to a church and she was having a bit of problems. So the pastor decided to give her some medication and she's ended up a whole bag of medication. Try to calm myself down a little bit. Said, "I tell you what," I said, "I want to get rid of the bag of medication. I want to spend some time and talk with you and deliver you from all the devils you got now."
Yes.
Yeah.
She said, "Please." "Father, don't let us stand." That's all I'm saying. "Father, don't let us stand." You know what Father tells me? He said, "I've given them my word." I said, "But Father, they don't even know. They've got my Bible. They've got my word. My word's more available than it's ever been available. My spirit of truth is everywhere." I said, "But Father, it's not their fault. It's this pastor's fault. It's those teachers' fault. It's these people who are saying that they are the representatives." And Lord constantly reminds me, no. They have my word. They have my word. They don't want to open my word. If they want to believe a lie, that's their choice. But Father, please. Father, please. You know what the Lord says? "You tell them." "Yes, sir. I'll tell them." And then perhaps there'll be some people sitting in this room here tonight that the fire of God's word begin to burn on the inside of you. The reality of his word and what he said begin to burn on the inside of you. And then you'll go and tell them. And then it'll be like a fire and it'll multiply. And oh my goodness gracious, what happens when you get some solidarity around the word of God? That's called the birthing of a move of God, a revival. Hallelujah, an awakening. That's right, baby. That's right. Because that's the anointing of the Holy Ghost called, set upon you for that purpose. That's why you're responding. That's why the anointing's on you so strong. It's the Spirit of the Lord saying, "This is exactly what you're supposed to do." Hallelujah. I'm not going to stand for it. I'm not going to tolerate it. Not in my life. In any way. Everybody gets the right to choose. I get to tell Satan and devils what they are going to do. I can declare to you, I can beseech you, I can go after you. People don't listen to me in this place. By and large, you don't listen. As long as you agree with me, you listen to me. If you don't agree with me, you do whatever you want to do. That's the way people treat the world. I mean, or rather, the world treats God, and people, and even people of God treat God. You don't have to find out. You know, all I'm telling you is what the Word of God says. And when you disagree with this, you're disagreeing with the Word. And you don't have to take my word for it, because you can start studying the Word and find out, oh, my goodness, he knows what he's talking about. Why, he just delivered the Word of God to us that I've been refusing all this time. People have forsaken honor. They've forsaken it. They've forsaken it. They have no values. It's all what's convenient. The CEO of Starbucks stands up and boldly says that if you believe that traditional marriage and homosexual marriage are different, or you think traditional marriage is superior to homosexual marriage, we don't want your business. So then for every time you go to Starbucks and you give them your business, you're saying, "Yes, I believe that homosexual marriage, traditional marriage are equivalent." Give me my other little sip. Under the goddess Astarte, they got her sign up there. So you go worship Astarte while you're doing it. And that's not covert. That's Astarte. That's Artemis, the goddess Diana, the queen of heaven. The mother of harlots. It's a picture. A Cyrene. One of her daughters, at least. Come on now. Oh, yeah, that's what goes on. That's what goes on. People all high and minded, you don't have any honor. That's why you can just cheat on God, go in your little corner and watch your pornography or whatever, because you don't have any honor. Because you don't know how sacred you are. You can just play around on the things of the Spirit. Walk all over the goodness of God. No more. In Jesus' name, you decide no more. I know a lot of us, when I'm talking right now to people on the web, God's blessed us to be able to reach a lot of people on the web. Father's just given us opportunity. I'm going to let it rip. And there's some of you in here need to hear it too. Don't cheat on God. He's sacred. Look at what he's done for you. Hallelujah. Get yourself some zeal. Get yourself some zeal. Get yourself some holy zeal. Amen. If I was on a desert island and there was all there was there was a Starbucks there, and I would die if I didn't go there, I'd die.
Amen. Me too.
So I'm never going to stand up and defy God under the symbol of the Queen of Heaven.
Me too.
Just like they did back when they worshipped during the time of Jezebel, because that's who she worshipped. That's her goddess. As they all got drunk, huh? And did all their crazy things. Come on now, people. Come on, get some discernment. People in this modern age don't even believe in demons. And they're full of them. You're supposed to have a spirit of discernment, know what's going on. You're supposed to be able to feel this stuff. So you can cast it out. You have no fellowship with it. Grab a hold of the authority of son. Start living a sanctified life. Quit giving me this nonsense about some process. Because I never seen anybody go through some process and gain any ground. Go ahead and accept what God's given and live it. Live it. Live a sanctified, separated, consecrated life. Come out from among them, be separate, says the Lord, and I will receive you. And touch not the unclean thing. And I'll be your God and you'll be my people. And I'll be your father and you'll be my sons and my daughters. Come on now. I'm not mad. But I am extremely passionate and angry against all the things that Satan's allowed to get away with in the camp of the Most High. And all the things that are going on. I'm telling you right now, you listen to me, preachers, I'm coming at you. Because Father, this is what Father's going to do. He's going to let me come at you. And these big mausoleums you call your great churches are coming down. They're going to be seen to be the sepulcher of rotten bones they are. Full of dead men's bones. It's coming down. It's coming down. Father's, because Father in his grace and his mercy is going to raise up the millennials. The millennials are coming, the hungry for the word. The hungry for the spirit. Hallelujah. I want everybody to stand with me. I want you to know, I want everybody in this place to understand how holy these things are. It's not a question about God's love. It's a question about the issue tonight is about that which is sacred and that which is holy. People speaking all kinds of nonsense, declaring all kinds of things, being bold, speaking with that big mouth that the Antichrist has. Big Antichrist mouth, always defying, always defending themselves. Always saying God doesn't understand. It's time to repent, get right with God. In Jesus' name. Peter, this is a church, a radical church that is set apart for the purposes of God. You listen to me. This is a church, a radical church, set apart for the purposes of God. Not for you to run over with any kind of idea and thing that you believe. You listen to me. You bring me the word of God, and I'm interested in hearing it. Because that's all that belongs in here. It's about time everybody be willing to conform to the word of God. Bring us the word of God. Declare the word of God. I wasn't going to say this, but I'm going to go ahead and do it. I know a preacher who put a microphone in the women's bathroom in the nursery so he could identify the women who are constantly going in the bathroom and spilling their complaint and their offense, and always one or two spilling over onto the masses and contaminating the whole place. I've never done that. There's no microphone in the bathroom. I thought about it, but only for a second. Because I got discernment of the Holy Ghost. So I already know who's got the complaint. And I want to be, you know, we talk in general terms because we want to be able to just talk to you people and get you into a place where you just say, Lord, I'm gonna quit living like the devil. I meant to say something. You listen to me. You either living like the Holy Ghost or you're living like the devil. There's no place in between. Decide tonight that you want to be led by the Holy Ghost. You want to live in the Holy Ghost, move with the Holy Ghost, walk in the Holy Ghost. Be taught of the Holy Ghost. Speak by the Holy Ghost. Be sacred. Let your mouth be sacred. Let the words of your mouth be like sacrifices. Something that's bringing forth praise and honor. Something that's blessing, not cursing. Something that's bringing life and not death. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, let us hear it. Come on, Zora Mekiasha. Come on, let us hear it. Come on, let the parable sifre ne yapakiasost. See, these are the times that I really need an interpreter. Because many times I get stuck in the realms of the Holy Ghost and I can't speak the English language. And if I just had an interpreter. Can be interpreted. And Father wants to give you the ability. Hallelujah. 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 I want you, every person in this place tonight, I want you to turn your life completely over to what Jesus said about you. Hallelujah. I want you to completely turn your life over to every good thing that Father has fashioned for you. I want you to step into the midst of Christ Jesus and begin to live in Him from here on in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let every desire be conformed to Him and matured into His desires. Let every passion be conformed to Him and mature into His passions. Let every attitude, let every emotion, let every appetite. Hallelujah. Just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Just begin to pray. Oh, ha ha, ha ha, ha ha, ha. All ye temples of the Lord, ha ha. All ye everlasting gates, open up the doors and let the King of Glory come rushing in. Ha ha, ha. Brabatanda de beshikirina la mabarehe. Danda be eshe irimanda rabakishi. Adoboto retishi. Membrende de bangando la musicande de bevre bebeki si ado lo mungabana ne menishi ene ne mandi beki. Mamra mama mana nene nene, urra mama mana nene nene, zurra mama nana nene nero, zurra mama mama mana urana, susu nene nene ngeli nene numa dosiki nene numa doro, diri nana mana nene eres. I want everybody from the ages of 9 to 19. I want you to just come stand here. Ages 9 to 19. Come stand here. Ruth Anna and Elizabeth, come here. Can I have you I'm going to have you just get your lift your hands towards heaven. Listen, if you're a teenager and you're not in Ruth Anna's youth group, you get your parents get you in so that you don't miss out on connecting with what's coming out of the glory spout. You don't miss out on connecting with the body of Christ, because you're not going to get what is happening in a missed church in your living room. Oh, you're on the camera? I was wondering where you came from. Hallelujah. Jacqueline, you come up here and stand with Louis. Then you're going to help. We're going to pray. Now, girls, I want to just go right down the line and just start knocking them over in the anointing. Start knocking them over in the anointing. Just knock them over in the anointing. Just go ahead and receive. Go ahead and receive. There you go. Get on Jake. Get Jake. Anointing's all over him. Power of God's all over Jake. Bangala. Manjakai. Are you nine, Judah? Dude, you're a short nine. You can't back up. You can't be backing up like your parents. Don't back off. Don't back away from the anointing. Don't back away. Don't back away. Don't back away from the anointing. People back up. They just back up, back up, back. It's like you're running from God. Go ahead, receive. Go ahead, receive. Wow. I see great anointings. I see great giftings of the power of God. I see great mantles of the Spirit. Understand what God is doing. Don't let anything come or rob from you. Yeah. My. I tell you, the millennials are coming. They're coming. They're coming. Mamranda manjesu ramana. Birima mandoro mongoro si bandolo bosia. Hallelujah. 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 Get Look at those anointings. Look at those anointings. Supernatural divine empowerment. All that's got to be done is mentored by the Holy Ghost in Holy Ghost meetings. All that's got to be done is protected against the violence of the world and every satanic attack. Come on, people. Jesus. 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 I see and I feel a radical display of the power of God and of His glory being manifest through a people who set themselves only for the Lord and only for His divine purposes. I see it happening. I see it happening in a radical way among the millennials. I see it happening. I feel it so strong. I pray in the name of Jesus. I don't care if you're 80, 90 years old. You can still get in the big middle. All you got to do is lay hold on God and say, Father, we're going all the way with You. Father, I'm going to be going all the way with You. I'm going to embrace everything that You said, and I'm going to start living it to the full. Oh, see the anointing. The fire of God is up here on my faces. If I just look at the anointing, it just does something to me. I can't contain myself. Ivribana monsitas. I'm going to tell you right now what they are doing and what they're pressing in for in the youth ministry in this place. And I know some people that are in their almost 30 years old that are coming to the meetings on the youth night on Thursday night. People, I'm going to tell you right now, if you have children, you have youth that are not in that, I guarantee you, you need to get them in it if you've got to hire a taxi to get yourself here. You don't want to make the mistake of isolating yourself from the church, the body of Christ, because this ain't gonna what happens in a church ain't going to happen in your living room. I don't care if you're an apostle, what's happening in the church ain't going to happen in your living room. And come press in with us. Mike is getting ready. Mike has offered himself up, as I said. Mike, just raise your hands towards heaven to live out the rest of his life on the mission field. So he's going to our mission training center. Going to become a very important human resource. I've already got him picked for the Kashmir Valley. Hallelujah. And we're going to send him tonight. He's not going far. He's going to be on the church campus there on the ranch in Oregon. We're actually going to be building the church this year in July. We need about $60,000 just to get the shell up. We want every one of you to just start sowing and saving for that. You start sowing and saving for it now. You know, it's not going to be any problem. Seeing $60,000 come together and see that thing go right up. Hallelujah. Pandokorosita. Hallelujah. Praise God. And Mike's also going to start leading the 1 o'clock prayer service there. Hallelujah. Urababaseya. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you that you brought Mike into this company. We thank you, Father, for the work of grace that has happened in this life. And I thank you for taking it to a whole nother dimension. Because, Lord, you're just looking for yielded vessels. And you have one right here. Ha-suki-nanaya. Subre-nasaya. Jesus' name. Signs, wonders, and miracles. Demonstration of the Holy Ghost and power in your life. Increase. 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 Come here, little brother. Come stand around here. Lift your hands towards heaven. I see this willingness to do anything, go anywhere, stand in the midst of whatever for Jesus. I see such a radical, sold out kind of moshe. You can lean on Mike, you don't care. I'ma say, hallelujah. I'm Banda Sheka. Hallelujah. Elizabeth, run with the fire of the Holy Ghost. Elizabeth, stand up in the greater dimension of the anointing that has been made available to you. Take hold of the Spirit of God and the power of God and the affections and the emotions of your life like never before. Mambranda Sekia. Jesus. Mighty. Geneva. Hana Sateya. Hanasara. Nyanfras. Nyanfras. Namangesh. Mambandalekis. Indaya Steyanaya. Indaina Seyaya. Moha. Mohotiyapa. Mayana. Miana. Jacqueline. Jacqueline. Babrasatan. Mambande Yafra. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus. Masito Mateo Pai. Jesus now. Mambande. Ha. Ha. Hanamona. Hanamona Hai. Hanamona Haya. Zur Mandaya. Zur Mamana. Zur Mamana. Someone in here, you're having to deal with chest pains. You have issues in, I don't know that it's necessarily the heart. Be caused by other things. So on the left side of your body, I want you to come and pray for you right now. Sometimes anxiety can do the same thing. I'm break the thing tonight. Anybody else? Healing anointing of the heavens here. Power of God's here. I command in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that this pain leave out of your body and go now. Not return. Cannot return in Jesus' name. Lo risate. Nanglai na busikina. Nandago sibretishia. There it is. Goes from you. Hallelujah. My dear brother, you have pain in your chest. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, this pain leaves you. What's your name?
James.
James, in Jesus' name, by the authority of the name of Jesus Christ, this heart is fine. In Jesus' name. This chest and this pain in this chest goes from you and does not return. Ah, Ramama. Father, I thank you for your anointing upon James. Father, I ask you for a divine explosion in his life of your power and of your glory. Father, that everything that you described in your word, James will begin to grab a hold of it by the power of the Holy Ghost and live it out. Raise up, I pray, in Jesus' name, a mighty weapon and instrument. It's time now in Jesus' name. You take a hold of that which Father has chosen you for and separated you for. You take a hold of the family ring, as it were, and you begin to live this out in Jesus' name. Pain out. How are you doing over here? Huh? Pain gone?
Yes.
My Yeshiel. So the Lord says, and we say to him, oh, thou, oh, Lord, our shield about me, my glory, the lifter of my head. Oh, thou, oh, Lord, our shield about me, my glory, and the lifter of my head. That's what you're singing, huh? Can you hear it? Can you hear it in your mind?
Yes.
Can you hear it in your heart?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. No more earthly, my heavenly, no more fleshly, spiritually. Out. Pain goes out. Yeah. Caught away in spiritual realm. Caught away in the glory realm. In a heavenly place. In a joyful place. Caught away with the daylight. Fills your heart and views your face. There we go. You know, tonight as we're worshiping, people do not understand this, but when you begin to give yourself over to the realms of the Holy Ghost with total abandonment, and you get developed in it as you give yourself more and more over with total abandonment to the realms of the Holy Ghost and praise and thanksgiving. Sickness and disease is broken there. Gifts, mantles are received there. There's more activity going on in the realm of praise. It's one of the most eternal things that you and I participate with. I've seen more people healed, more people delivered, more people filled up in the realms of this glory. And I pray in Jesus' name you'll take hold of it. Hallelujah. Everybody I prayed for, you're healed. I'm going to tell you right now, everybody I prayed for, you're healed. That old chest pain's gone. Hallelujah. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Mando ribiki. Mando biki stapa. Fiery healing anointing. Fiery preaching of the word with signs and wonders. The great demonstration of the Holy Ghost and power. What's up? Huh? For him? What? Oh, you want to be close. Good. Just always be close. That's good. That's what you do. That is the right thing to do. That is wisdom from above. I said, "Okay, see what you want." She said, "I just want the little guy to be close to what's going on." That's the right thing to do. It's better than any clothes you'll ever be able to buy for him. It's better than any toys you'll be able to buy for him. any earthly possession you'd be ever to give him. Set him in a place. The things of the Spirit. Where he begins to be more a part of that which the Holy Ghost is doing than popular trends of men. People act as they do because they've just set in, they've been a part of just what is normalized within a society. They come under the same spirit. They don't even realize it, but they come under the same spirit by accepting that. And they just walk around looking the same, acting the same, same gesture, same issues. Father's called us over into another realm. Holy Ghost realm. The world can't even relate to us, can't even imagine why on earth we've got a smile that's going from ear to ear and busting loose in between. Why are we so excited about our praise and worship and the things of unto the King? These divine expressions, this power and glory divine. But if they sick in the disease, they know where to come to. Hallelujah. Zezuzah, 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 Mandalaya, Mandalaya, Mandalaya. There is a great harvest at Pete's Coffee. Basa Kerenea Shipadale. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hagadaya. Prandasaya. Ingayataya. Yeah. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. J-O-Y. Deep inside. Barely flow through me. Hallelujah. J-O-Y. Deep inside, barely flow through me. Amen. That's what she's supposed to be doing. That's right. Thank you, Jesus. Basha, 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 Bashareya, Bashareya, Basha, Basha, Bashareya, 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 the wellsprings of life. Bashareya, Zu Namande Polangi, okay, okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, is there anybody else sick in here? What's up? Come up here. Should go back over there. What's up? What's wrong? In Jesus' name. Now, Father, your servant Stuart has to be around these babies all day long. He takes care of babies. He runs a nursery. Father, he's a pediatrician. Some of you are like, he's running a nursery. Father, your servant Stuart can take and step into a realm where all these sicknesses and diseases have no power over him.
Thank you.
And once they have no power over you, there's no limit to what you can do. Yes. People just walk into the office and they get healed.
Yes.
So now in the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you for this grace that causes a steward to step over in this realm.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Mondeshteya. Rabota. What's up?
My lungs are congested.
Your lungs are congested?
Yes.
Why you reckon they're congested? From work are you in?
No, breathing dust, bad dust.
That's what I meant. We're from breathing bad.
Not at work. I haven't been breathing bad dust for really work. It's my parents' house. The dust is bad.
Oh, in the house that you're living in?
On the weekends, yeah.
Jesus, just as your aunt. Father, I just thank you for Joseph, your servant. Joseph, step into radical. Step into Word. Word radical. Word of life radical. See, God's Word is spirit and life. It's living and it's powerful. And when we begin to think it, when we begin to speak it, when we begin to live by it, when it becomes our identity, this is who we are, then we can begin to declare it in a way that before just reciting it, just reciting the scripture, can't compare to you living the word and speaking it. Now in the name of Jesus Christ, I command this infection go out of your lungs. You're harassing, tormenting thing. Go out of these lungs now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Now your lungs clear now in Jesus' name. They begin to clear right now in Jesus' name. Man, it's so good to see you standing here with your hands stretched out. What do you want from heaven?
Everything.
Everything. Receive right now everything that you're able to receive. Now, in Jesus' name. Right now, the rivers begin to flow out of your belly. Now, in Jesus' name. Amen. And everything that would try to stand in the way must be removed.
Amen.
Now, in Jesus' name, Mamongande, Atakido Bokota Ade, Mambrosisist, Evritast. Jesus. Out of your belly flows these glorious expressions of the Holy Ghost. This is Uda. Yeah, there's joy in paradise. Halalaka. Nigga. Yeah, brother. Hallelujah. There, my man, my man. Dear the man, I'm Jay, I'm in the sea, I am on gain of mine. Jaleman Jay, I'm in jail, I'm on gear, I'm on jail, I'm on gain and gain. Get a Maya Naya Naya, 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 and you shine, I am an eye, and you shale, my eye, I'm an eye high. Oh, my Naya, hey, aha. Oh, I am Sahara high. May Hale Hosa. May Rahalahada. May Mosheo. Mumanana high. Sheo. Sheo. Maneo. Manoya. Manu. Manahea. Shea. Boa. Oh, the fire and fire of God, the streams of the Lord.
flowing through you now. Flowing through you. Oh. Flowing through you now. Flowing through.
Mando se kibri. As dorane. As doraneshta. Urs darane fliteke. Mabande.
Take hope. Take hope. Right now. Take hope. Mama se ki. Take hope right now.
Mama mane. Mama mane. Mama mane. Oh, Kiano Kokila, je brunst. I see the glory of the Lord in his temple. I see the glory of the Lord in his temple. I see the glory of the Lord in his temple. I see the glory of the Lord in the sanctuary. I see the glory of the Lord in this temple. I see the glory of the Lord in the sanctuary. Mama ne, mama na.
Chrissy, come here. I see the glory of the Lord in this temple. I see the glory of the Lord in the sanctuary.
Hallelujah. Mama nena. Mama manena, mama manena, mala la la man, mama manena, mala la la man, mina na manere, mama la la man, zera na mandan, la la man, la la manen, la la na ene ne ne nun.
Father, thank you for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Brataki aromoxatari gelia, mambresi salalindu. Maraca tarabo shata renekeya, morasata irekeya, mombras.
Yeah.
And what you were saying is, I know, Lord, that I am separated by you, Father, as a chosen vessel unto you, Father. And God, I pledge myself to you to live fully for you, to do those things that you've called and purposed me to do. To not lose sight of the fact that it's you that it is at work on the inside of me, and I don't have to look for myself or figure out how it's going to take place or how it's going to happen. And right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, you also receive this wonderful gift of interpretation of tongues. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
For you decided and resolved yourself to live out the life of God. And that's why the spirit of the son, the spirit of the daughter in this case, hallelujah. The spirit, you know the son, there's neither male nor female. See, the fact of it is, even the daughters have the spirit of the son. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Because you find yourself in Jesus Christ alone. Hallelujah. So the spirit of the son is in the daughters. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. That's just the divine power of God's glory. That's why we come in church. Just get over here in the Basataya. Get over here in what everybody else calls strange and weird. But I tell you right now, it works out the miracles, the signs and the wonders, the working of the mighty power of God, the ability to walk in a heavenly place in the heavenly realm, to do the works of Jesus Christ, to flow in the things of the Spirit,
to live in the river, to walk in the joy, unspeakable and full of glory, the peace that passes understanding, a love that goes beyond all knowledge.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, right there. Yeah,
Manjaya Paha.
Yeah.
Breve barre hase. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. 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 Yes, you will walk in divine help.
Yes.
You will walk a divine strength.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus.
You just stay right over there in joy. Yes. You let me do the prophesy.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes. There's
a lot you can receive when you're caught away in joy. Yeah, it is. There's a lot you can receive when you're caught away in thanksgiving. The fact of it is, you can't receive anything from heaven unless you're caught away in joy and thanksgiving. Because that's the realm of faith. You can't receive anything outside of the realm of faith. Faith is moving with God. Faith's doing what God's doing. Ha! Ha! It's a twist and shout. Hallelujah. 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 Ha 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 ha. Oh, 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 Money, you belong to heaven. You're not of this world. You don't fit in. Take your place among the mighty men. Take your place among the sons of God. Those brought out of darkness
into the light of his love to show forth his praises. Flowing in the Holy Ghost is so much more, so much more, so much more. Take hold of him. Take hold. Take hold. Lay hold. Lay hold. I'll lay hold of the one who's anointed you, who's filled you, who's chosen you, who's elected and ordained and predestinated you, has called you. Lay hold of him. Lay hold Mamananas. Mamane. Mamananas. 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 Father, everything in our life we gladly give and surrender and sacrifice to you. Pour our lives out like a drink offering, O God, upon the altar. Let our lives be holy and acceptable as we live as this wonderful living sacrifice, as an offering, a whole burnt offering turned into smoke for you. O God, for we would rather have you and that which you propose for our life than anything this world can afford or do. There is a realm of glory. There's a realm of praises. There's a realm of heaven that will build your faces. There's a place of faith now, and the great outworking of the Holy Spirit, greater than the days of old in the former times, for it's the time of the rain, the early and the latter rain. And as you hunger for the word, and as you listen to the word, the spoken word of God, and those things which the Spirit of the Lord declares, established and is written and set forth for all men, whosoever will hear, you'll rise up in the ability and the doing of it. For Father places within a heart a great hunger, a great thirsting, a great hearing, and out of that there arises a great ability to do it, to function in it. So just continue to hunger. Just continue to lay hold on the word of God. Hallelujah. Majekam Rushikande. Jesus. Takuyin emekikas. Biristam blakaya. Bliristapronakika. Doropakulina machekikanika. Sipakatokina patusit. Milata. Milata, milata, milata moroposita. Jesus. Rain showers. Heaven showers. Here kind of hard to take. Hakatana. Manakeha. Mambretish. Mandeshi. Mandeshi.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus. Mambeki and a masateti and makalaki nika paka. Exia to romasatandele kipa. Efefe. Mandeles. Ima. Elastis. Mandandele nainusi. Mandandele nainusi. Mandandele nainusi. Mandandele nainusi. Mandandele nainusi. Mount up with wings like an eagle. Running up, be weary. Walking, not be faint. Great things. Yes, Lord. So that you will say, the Lord has done great things for me. For he who is mighty, hallelujah, has visited me and poured out his blessings from on high. Yes, Lord. He who is mighty has done mighty things, great things for me. And let everybody say, he has done great things. He has done great things. He has done great things. He's great things, great for me. Let's say, he has done great things. He has done great things. He's done grandestus. Mandekia tus azuta dile bonuma. He has radicat. He's at la cusat. Usa si la paye. Manambo cabatibo a sitaro. He is atakinadu. Isata canino luraban, Isaro no si la vida lusofini. He has done great things. Oh, he has done great things. My God has done great things, great things, great things he's done for me. Oh God, he's done great things. He is mighty. Oh God, he's done great things. Oh, great things, great things, great things. He's done great things for. Will everybody just stand? Find a bunch of people around you, hug them, tell them that you love them, bless them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. If you see somebody on the floor caught away in glory, don't you just leave them alone. Hallelujah. They'll be around shortly. Hallelujah. Honor the Lord with your substance and with all the first fruits of your increase. So shall your barns be full and your vats shall overflow with new wine. Prove me, says the Lord, with your tithes and offerings, and see if I will not open heaven and pour you out a blessing more than you can contain. For they that sow in tears shall reap in joy, says the Lord. And if you sow generously, you shall reap generously. And I shall cause all grace to abound unto you, that in all things you will have all sufficiency. Hallelujah. And as you give, know this, that Father will give to you, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men begin to heap into your bosom. For there is a blessing, a spiritual blessing, that Father has for you that goes beyond anything that you can think or ask. And God, who multiplies the seed that is sown, will multiply your seed to you. Hallelujah. Ha ha ha. Harabata hikiyah.